here we are in Paris, and we're actually stood by the Grand Arch in La Défense. That's the name of the area, La Défense Grand Arch. And just to the left of the Grand Arch, with the Imax Dome Theatre. And there's the entrance. Fortunately, this escalator is to take us up to the dome. Dome Imax, 180 degrees, the cinema spectacle. However, we did get to go to see Mysteries of Egypt at the Imax Dome, or the Omnimax. And look what we see here. A glass wall looking into the projection room. There's projectionists rewinding or setting up to rewind one of the platters. Not the film we're seeing today, I might add. And in the background, to the right of the projectionist, you'll see the sound mag follower. I'm afraid we're looking through the wall of the projection room. Now, this Omnimax dome is part of a massive centre. Now, see the tracks to its projector actually slides up and down to its porthole. I can never understand why they just didn't build a projection room at that level so the projector could be around the porthole and just shoot straight out. But the Canadians must know better on this one, I'm sure. It's their technology. See, that's where the projector goes up to. And here we are, we've got a film being rewound here from a previous show. As I said before, this is not Mysteries of Egypt. And there's the mag follow in the background. And there's the projector center screen. Now, the gates on these projectors is a circular gate. And the film runs horizontally as a normal cinema platter operates. Here's a close-up of the projector. Not like what we're not used to seeing in our cinemas, is it? It's an amazing piece of technology. There's a plate rewinding. There's a mag follower. The sound is actually got off disc, and if that fails, the mag follower is there as a backup. There's all the controls for it. Quite amazing, really. It's all controlled from this desk. Omnimax rolling loop projector. Notice the word elevator. And there's a projector again. And there's a 70mm horizontal framed print. Didn't realise this was an Omnimax until I actually got in. I thought it might have been, we're saying, 180 degrees. Quite amazing. This is all before I've actually been in to watch the film, but having seen the film and doing this video now, I can actually say, Omnimax films and IMAX films are basically not very good, but it's the feeling you get from them, you know, the ambience and the full 180 degree vision from left to right. Look at that leader, look at that film! We're looking at the gate, we've actually gained entry to the projection room. It's a bit of a coup for us here on the projection videos. Look at that! Wow! Look at the lens. That is the lens. It doesn't look much, does it? Look at it. That's amazing. But when it shows you on the big screen, how does it do it? Look at this gate. There we are, looking at the track. Take the projector up to its rightful place of projection. And we're now back at projector. Look at the way the film twists and turns around all those rollers. Just get back to where it lives on the platter. There's our young projection center. There's so good. Here's the side of the projector itself. Omnimax. There's a forklift truck in the background there. They use that to lift the prints on and off because they're showing four different prints a day. They need to lift it on and off. It's far too heavy on their own to do so. I'm not quite sure at this stage it's actually lifting the plate on and off. Or whether it's just a film. I would imagine it's just a plate. The projection's just closed the covers on the gates. Here we go, projector's going up now to its normal projection show position. Look at that go.